bio fertilizers. There are some which we are familiar, we are aware of those. One is rhizobia. It is found symbiotically. Then there are different types of rhizobia, like rhizobium trifolium, rhizobium leguminosarum. So they are found in symbiotic association with different plants. This is rhizobium leguminosarum. It is found in the roots of leguminous plant, because this has a gene called NIF gene, because of which it makes an enzyme called nitrogenase, and this nitrogenase works in anaerobic condition and it will fix nitrogen for the plant. And the leguminous plant, they have leg hemoglobin. Leg hemoglobin acts like an oxygen scavenger, so it binds with oxygen wherever it is. So if it binds with oxygen, it removes that oxygen and creates anaerobic condition for the bacteria to work. This is symbiotic association, and it helps in nitrogen fixation. So if nitrogen is added into the soil fertility increases. Similarly, there is one more which is called Azolla anabana. Anabana is a blue-green alga, and its name is Anabana azolli. It is found in the leaf of Azolla. Azolla is an aquatic pteridophyte. It grows in water, and it is said that if we grow Azolla with paddy, with the rice plantation, then it increases the productivity by almost 20 to 30%, because wherever you grow Azolla, Anabana is always going to be there. Anabana is going to help in nitrogen fixation, so the plants will get more and more nitrogen. So productivity is definitely going to go up. Then there are mycorrhizae. Another symbiotic association is mycorrhiza, which is the association of fungus with the roots of higher plants. So here these fungi, they help in absorption of phosphate. Especially phosphate and then water absorption. So this is a beneficial thing for the plant. So you don't have to add, you know, the phosphate fertilizer or nitrogen fertilizer. You can rotate the crop. One crop which fixes nitrogen, the other crop which doesn't. So that the second crop gets the nitrogen which is fixed by the previous crop which was growing. So these rhizobium, azospirillum, azotobacter, these are free living ones. The azospirillum, azotobacter, these are free living nitrogen fixing. This is symbiotic nitrogen fixing. So if you can add these microbes into the soil, the nitrogen content, the mineral content of the soil anyways is going to increase. There is one more which is Frankia and Alnus. This is also a symbiotic association. Symbiotic associations are normally for nitrogen fixation. So Alnus, Frankia, in the root nodules of Alnus, then Anabana azolli, these are very common microbes where they help in increasing the soil fertility. So you can use them as biofertilizers. Cyanobacteria, like Anabana example we have taken here, Nostoc, Oscillatoria, they also help in increasing the soil fertility. So these are all microbes which can be used as biofertilizers.